In the last few days, we've talked to you about this controversy at a Bloomington farmers market. Well, now we are hearing from the vendor at the center of all of this controversy.
Yeah, the vendor now denying all ties to white supremacy right after the mayor held a press conference today in Bloomington explaining why the city is suspending the market for the next 2 weeks.
Fox 59's Kayla Sullivan joins us now in the studio tonight after sitting down exclusively with this vendor. What does the vendor have to say about all of this?
Well, Sarah Dye is the owner of Schooner Creek Farm, and she denies all accusations of being tied to white supremacy. However, those claims are what caused protesters on both sides of the issue to show up to the farmers market.
As an identitarian and an American, I am disgusted at the level of lies, misinformation, falsehoods, and intimidation by those who do not know me or my family.
Sarah Dye has been facing accusations of having ties to white supremacy. She says B-Town Antifa has been harassing her and her Schooner Creek family at the farmers market.
I have faith that the Bloomington Police Department will do their job and continue to do it well.
She denies ties to white supremacy.
We absolutely reject supremacy in all of its forms.
Dye is unsure how this became a farmers market issue.
Have you ever pushed your political views at the farmers market?
No, never. I'm just there to sell produce, as I have been for 9 years.
Now she says she's caught in the middle after the group 3% offered to defend her against Antifa. Dye says she told them police would handle the situation, but they showed up anyway.
Let me state the obvious. When conflict and tension are present in public gatherings, it is dramatically more difficult to protect public safety when firearms and other weapons are present and pervasive.
The city is working on solutions to make the farmers market safer. Some vendors think removing Schooner Creek is the best option.
They need to get them out of the market. No one feels safe with them there at the market. 2 weeks from now, if they're at the market, it's not going to matter how many police are around.
But removing the farm may open the city up to an expensive First Amendment lawsuit.
Maybe that's litigation that needs to be done. Maybe that's part of all of this white supremacist versus inclusiveness issue that needs to be aired in the courts.
Dye feels that would go against the very nature of what should be an inclusive market.
People come to the farmers market to celebrate a community event, to enjoy wholesome food and live music, and to leave their differences at home. And that's what we've done for 9 years, and that's what we plan to continue doing.
I spoke with the commanding officer of the 3% group, Gary Weddle, who came in support of Schooner Creek last Saturday. He says they didn't threaten anyone, but his group does stand against B-Town Antifa. He confirmed that they reached out to Sarah Dye after learning about this controversy on Facebook. I reached out to B-Town Antifa for comment, but the group said it does not do interviews with the media.
All right, a story we will keep following.